The COVID-19 crisis offered an unparalleled opportunity to reflect on how we live together in the city. Our dependencies, relationships, blind spots and processes, as well as our stories and mental models that hold our society together. The growing ubiquity of remote work and heightened public health awareness are now added to the long list of new developments that have been shaping our cities: the digitalization of commerce, growing real estate prices, the smart city project, migration and inequality, just to name a few. So we decided to start collecting individual responses in the city of Bern to this new situation, guided by the question, how can we individuals currently witnessing local and global events and their interrelatedness reimagine the city? And how can we support our communities to take agency for a regenerative transformation? And I will also give a little teaser of our findings. In the aftermath of the lockdown, we collectively long for the quietness, the slowing down, the clear skies and birdsong, the suddenly thriving flora and fauna in the city. We dream of the inner city becoming an elaborate labyrinth for learning, including Tatiana's women crafting their products in small workshops, Florin and Simon's open spaces filled with programs and services for a diverse audience, including drug users and art lovers, sport teams and music enthusiasts, Sabo and Ennis's art studios and small local theaters, community gardens that grow food rather than exotic plants, collective kitchens and playgrounds for children and adults, interactive spaces for learning, virtual art exhibitions, and citizen science laboratories deciphering the delicate transient lyrics of the lichen on rock faces of the Alps. Our city research and sensing revealed invalidation as the core issue, expressed in three divides through unfair or ignorant practices. We take a distance from people who are different, devaluing their experience. We discriminate people of color. We build education systems that create and reinforce a social divide. We see the inability of alternative culture to work with authority for common ground. We witness the unpaid or poorly paid work of caregivers and cleaners, gender practices with hidden agendas, and we see how we forget the fundamental integrity present in natural systems. On this continuing journey, we take in the view, listen in dialogues, then proceed in gentle processes to become more aware of our inner condition as well as our surroundings. We ask local people and organizations to hold conversations that matter so that we can learn together. We use CRU and system maps to make sense with people, a local expert host. We listen to the older and younger in systemic and personal ways of sensing and sense making of the inclusive fabric of regenerative cities.